Hi friends, how are you all? I'm sure you're doing great and you're doing good. So this is Sarabhijit again, conducting online classes for Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kokrajhar, for classes 9 and 10. A common topic for same common topic for class 9 as well as for class 10. The name of the topic is Mail March. This is part of word processing, word processor. Class 9 we were doing word processing, okay, and this is the last part of the word processing. And in your book it is given as digital documentation, okay, digital documentation. In class 9 book it's given unit 3. In class 9 book it is given unit 3, and this is digital documentation, this is mail march. One thing I would like to explain before I start my classes, or before I start my today's class, means in my class, in this subject, especially information technology, actually I need to project a screen, I need to project a computer or any laptop or a screen, so that I can guide you with the steps of whatever I am explaining or whatever I am trying to explain. So now in place of a projection, or in place of projecting, or instead of projecting a screen, if I project my face and I go for a video calling class, then it is not going to help you, my dear students, okay. Means with the help of my face, I cannot guide you with the steps that what I am trying to explain you, because my subject is a totally practical based subject. This will not go with other subjects. In other subjects, it is okay, fine. By projecting a face, by getting the expression, you understand what is, you know, what is literature or what is language or what is this and what is that. But in my subject, projecting a screen is very, very important. That is why I am not going with video, live video classes. So in live video classes also, if I go with the live video classes, whatever it is, even if it is a Google Meet or something, some meet, there also I have to project a screen instead of projecting my face. So now coming to interaction. Now interaction can be done in this way also. Suppose you take my class first of all. After that, if you get any doubt or any confusion, you can certainly you can text me, you can call me. Then with that confusion, we can go for a video chatting or video calling, or there may be a doubt clearing session, or I may give you a doubt clearing session, or even if in the doubt clearing session also I have to project a screen, my face will not help you to clear your doubt, because my subject is a practical subject. I hope you understand. Now coming to today's topic, and this is the last topic in digital documentation. In the very next we will be starting on this Microsoft Excel, Introduction to Spreadsheet, chapter 9, Introduction to Spreadsheet. And now we are in chapter 10, Introduction to Spreadsheet. Now we are in chapter 9. This is the last part of digital documentation, mail march. So this mail march is a very important lesson for you all, so please get it nicely, okay. And if there is any doubt, any confusion, or any type of interactions that you want to do with me, I am ready to give you time, or we can mutually find a time where we can go for a video calling, okay, where we can go for a video calling. And if you want to hear anything from me live, if you want to hear anything from me, this is also I am doing live, okay. Yes, but if you want to see my face and you want to live, get anything live, clarification of any confusion or doubt, we can do it. We can mutually set a time, and with the help of that we can go for a WhatsApp video calling, okay. No need for that Google Meet or anything else. In WhatsApp video calling, I can take 4 to 5 students at a time in WhatsApp video calling nowadays. Nowadays WhatsApp has given that features that I can add up to 8 students for video calling. If you have any type of problems, the way I am taking classes, I am sure and very confident that you don't have any problem. and every doubt and confusion can be cleared by watching my videos. So let's start mail merge. Now what is mail merge? Now see, generally in business as well as in personal matter, it is often required to send letter with similar information to different people. Similar information to different people. Suppose, think of this letter. I am glad to send you invitation for my birthday party, dear friend. Now to suppose Samuel. Now I am writing here Samuel, then I will go to print, take a printout for Samuel. Okay. Next I have to send to suppose Manas, M-A-N-A-S. Next I will again go to print and I will take a printout of this. Next I will be typing Manas C suppose. And again Manasi, and suppose village is Sudempuri, and next is district is Kokrajhar. Kokrajhar Assam 783370. Suppose this is the address I have to put. Now you see, can you imagine if I have to type this for another 50 of my friends, how tiring job it will be? Are you getting me? If I have to type like this for another 100 friends, suppose I may be more than 100 friends, I may invite more than 100 of my friends, or I may use the same letter for 100 of my friends, the same letter. The letter required the same, required the name address of each recipient to be printed on the top. As you can see that the printing is done on the top. Changing the address each time would be very long process and a wastage of time and effort. Okay. Correct, wastage of time and effort. Now mail merge features of Microsoft Word is used to combine a data source which contain mutual content the addresses of all the recipient with the main document, and it will save your time and energy to send letter to multiple addresses. The concept is clear to you. Now when I show you practically, then you will understand that what will happen. Okay, so without typing, actually I don't want to type it. Okay, I don't want to type it again and again here. A source I am going to create. A data source I am going to create with the help of mail merge. Let's do it. It is very easy. It's not a rocket science. Very easy. Let's do it. Fine. So to do this, if you are in home tab, so from home tab come to the mailing tab. Achha, before that create your document first of all. Create your letter, the letter that you want to send to many of your friends. I will just close this and start everything newly. Okay, so this is the letter that I am going to send to 100 of my friends. Okay, so for the time being I will take 5 of my friends. 100, it will be a lengthy video. Then 5 and 500 is same. If I do for 5, I can go for 5000 also, not a big issue. Okay, let's do it. So first my letter is ready. Then what are the things that I want to be printed on top? Suppose I want to print name of the person, I want to print village of the person, I want to print district of the person. That's all. These three information I want to print, and with these three information I will create a data source. Now how? Let's do it. Come to mailing. If you are in home tab, from home tab please come to mailing. Once you come in mailing, you will get this option, start mail merge. Can you see this start mail merge option? Just click here and take the last option, step by step mail merge wizard. Click here. Once you click here, on the left hand side you can see this is the mail merge this one dialog box has come here. The mail merge dialog box has come here. Now you can see in the very first it is given select document type. So my document type is, for the time being, it is letter document type. Next we have email message, envelope, labels, directory. Now for the time being it is a letter type of document mine. So select letter, and from down you can see next wizard step. Okay, it is given here, next wizard step, from down, exactly in down. Just click here. Once you click here, then again you see in the very first in the beginning of the dialog box, in the first part of the dialog box, it is given here.